Yes, yes, as you've said countless times before.
Harumph! Well then, if you're going to be like that, perhaps it's best I take my leave. A good day to you, sir. I said good day!
Yes, yes, go. Leave me to my ceaseless responsibilities and burdens.
How rude! Can't be bothered to host an old friend for a decade or two. Pelagius III. Now, surely even you know about Pelagius's decree. On his deathbed, and this was inspired, he forbade death! That's right! Death outlawed! Inside the mind of Pelagius, silly. Oh, is it your first time? Really? Ooh, what kind of message? A song? A summons? Wait, I know! A death threat written on the back of an Argonian concubine. Ah, those are my favorites. Well, spit it out, mortal. I haven't got an eternity. Actually, I do. Little joke, but seriously, what's the message? Were you now? By whom? Wait! Don't tell me. I want to guess. Was it Molag? No! Little Tim? The Toymaker's son, huh? What? The ghost of King Lysandus? Or was it one? Yes! Stanley, the talking grapefruit from Passwall! Ha ha! I'm wrong on all accounts, aren't I? Ha! No matter! Honestly, I don't want to know. Why ruin the surprise? But more to the point, do you, tiny, puny, expendable little mortal, actually think you can convince me to leave? Because that's crazy! You do realize who you're dealing with here. Jolly good guess. But only half right. I'm a mad god. The mad god, actually. It's a family title. Gets passed down from me to myself every few thousand years. Now you can call me Anne-Marie. But only if you're partial to being flayed alive and having an angry immortal skip rope with your entrails. If not, then call me Sheogorath. Daedric, Prince of Madness. Charmed. Now that's the real question, isn't it? Because honestly, how much time off could a demented Daedra really need? So, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to leave. That's right, I'm done. Holiday complete. Time to return to the humdrum day-to-day. On one condition. You have to find the way out first. Well, good luck with that. Ha! I do love it when the mortals know they're being manipulated. Makes things infinitely more interesting. Care to take a look around? This is not, I dare say, the Solitude Botanical Gardens. Have you any idea where you are? Where you truly are? Welcome to the deceptively verdant mind of the Emperor Pelagius III. That's right! You're in the head of a dead, homicidally insane monarch! Now, I know what you're thinking. Can I still rely on my swords and spells and sneaking and all that nonsense? Sure. Or you could use the Wabachak! Huh? Didn't see that coming, did you? Do you mind? I'm busy doing the fish stick. It's a very delicate state of mind. Oh, good choice! Well, good for me. I find everyone being out to get you so terribly entertaining. You might find it less so. You see, Pelagius' mother was let us say, unique. Although I suppose, in the grand scheme of things, she was fairly average for a septim. That woman wielded fear like a cleaver. Or did she wield a cleaver and make people afraid? I never get that part right. Oh, but she taught her son well. Pelagius learned at a very early age that danger could come from anywhere, at any time, delivered. The objective here is simple, you simpleton. Use your wabaja to defeat the enemy, while they do the same. Oh, I thought you'd never figure it out! With the threat gone, Pelagius is under the delusion that he's safe. Means you've helped him out, sort of. And we're that much closer to home. You've headed down the path of dreams. Unfortunately for you, Pelagius suffered night terrors from a young age. All you need to do is find something to wake our poor Pelagius up. You'll find his terrors easy to repel, but persistent. To crow about. With Pelagius up and about, you're moving right along. We'll both be home in no time. Now this is a sad path. Pelagius hated and feared many things. Assassins, wild dogs, the undead, pumpernickel. But the deepest, keenest hatred was for himself. The attacks he makes on himself can be seen here fully. They're always carried out on the weakest part of his fragile self. But self-loathing enhances Pelagius' anger. Ah, but strength with every hit. You must bring the two into balance.
Is that it? That's the best you can do.
Wonderfully done. Pelagius is finally ready to love himself.
Here we go.
Even listen.
Huh?
Fixed is such a subjective term. I think treated is far more appropriate, don't you? Like one does to a rash or an arrow in the face. Ah, but no matter. Heartless mortal that you are, you've actually succeeded and survived. I am first to honor my end of the bargain. So, congratulations. You're free to go. I have been known to change my mind. So, go. Really. Pelagius Septim III, once the mad emperor of Tamriel, now so boringly sane. I always knew he had it in him. Well, I suppose it's back to the Shivering Isles. A trouble Haskell can get into while I'm gone simply boggles the mind. Let's make sure I'm not forgetting anything. Clothes? Check. Beard? Check. Luggage? Luggage? Now, where did I leave my luggage?
Master, you've taken me back. Does this mean we're going home? Oh, happy times. I can't wait to...
Yes, yes, that's quite enough celebration. Let's send you ahead, shall we? As for you, my little mortal minion, feel free to keep the wabba-jack as a symbol of my... I'll just take the damn thing. You take care of yourself now. And if you ever find yourself up in New Sheo, do look me up. We can share a strawberry tart! Ha ha! Ta-ta!
Yes?
May the gods watch over your battles, friend. Anyone with a stout heart like yours is welcome here.
tight out here. I don't know how you stand it.
I welcome you, friend. How may I serve you? Quite the opposite, in fact. The soldiers are some of our best customers, for we offer supplies and wares they cannot obtain by other means. It was Rissad's idea to come here now, while the land is in turmoil. Where others saw only danger, he saw opportunity. May your road lead you to warm sands.
Looks like you had no trouble.
The effects have already been felt. The Ice Runner has failed to dock on time. Without the lighthouse, the Ice Runner will have swung wide of the western shoal and run aground on the eastern coast. My sister Deja will be at the wreck with our Blackblood Marauders. She knows to expect you.
Already lost. You dare challenge me?
Victory for Sovngarde!
Prepare to die.
Yes? Need something?
My brother told me you were coming. I'm supposed to give you what you've earned. Ha! I'm afraid the loot's already been moved. You've been useful to the Black Bloods, though. You've earned a quick death.
Mm-hmm. Where'd you come from?
No more!
I knew I heard something.